So anything less than 10 seconds is usually a fluke. So please, okay, so can we begin now, Satyam? You're okay, you're fine now, right? So here is the first question. Take your time and solve. Don't really rush through. It will take some time for you to get to the answer. You know, already three people have marked it. Never mind. Take your time. 100 seconds have been given for all the questions. Okay, so last 10 seconds, I hope you have reached to the last step. So options could be a little confusing, okay? Nice. So let me see how was the performance. So not everyone could get it. So why, you know, so people got confused. I told you, right? See, most of you got confused between the two options. So that's what will be tested also. Yeah, so that's wrong. So answer is 42nd. So the number has to be greater than okay, so here, so few things are very clear here. First term is 30, right? Yeah, so A is 30 and D is, how much was the D? If you see, this is nothing but minus 3/4. This is D. Right, then you have to get first negative term. So let's say nth term is first negative term and it is less than zero. That's the first negative term. So tn is a plus n minus 1 times d should be less than zero. Okay, what is a? 30. 30 plus n. So what is n? I don't know. N minus 1 into minus 3/4 must be less than zero. Correct. This is how you have to solve it. Now what, if you see, this is 30 and minus 3/4 n and plus 3/4 should be less than 0. That means 3n/4 should be greater than what? 30 plus 3/4. Okay, so 3n should be greater than what? 4 into 30 plus 3/4. Which is 120 plus 3, that is 123, right? So 3n is greater than 123. So n has to be greater than 123/4. Am I right? So far so good. Any problem? 123 by, oh, I'm sorry, by 3. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. So that by 3. So what is this number? This is somewhere equal to 41, right? It is actually n is greater than 41. You are getting n is greater than 41. So n is greater than 41. So immediate number which is greater than 41 is 42. Since most of you have, a few of you definitely, 22 of you have clicked this one. Wrong. So 42 is the right answer. Got it? So this was given because I know most of, you can see almost 50% of the people would have got this till this level. not 50%, almost 100% of you. But then at this stage, you messed it up. Okay, so n was greater than 41, not equal to. There was equal to sign missing. So hence, got this clear? Right? So this was a mistake because of that. Okay. Next, let's go to first leaderboard. Okay, so now which Aniket is this, Mungara or Mungara? Good. Chalo, next question on the screen, guys. Take time, it will take time. So don't just mark like that. 10th common term between the two APs, 3, 7, 11, 15, 1, 6, 11, 16 is. Again, there will be close options, so hence do not make mistake over there. Okay, so last 8 seconds. Okay, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, most of you have got it correct. Very good. So that means you found it easy. So let me solve it. And it was very, very simple actually. So if you see, what's it? What is this? So first term is 3, 7, 11 here. So 11 is the common term, first common term, right? So hence you will see the common terms will be what? 11, and then the next common term, can you predict the next common term will be? What is the next? 31, very good. Next common term is 31. How is it? How is this done actually? So here you have to find out the first common term. And the next is 31, so common difference is 20. So it will, this also will be an AP, right? So 11, 31, 51, 71, all of these will be in this AP. So you have to basically find the 10th term of this, right? So the 10th term will be how much? 11 plus 9 into 20, which is 11 plus 180, which is 191, right? How do you find the second common term? So what is the technical way of doing this is this. So what is the common difference here? First AP has a common difference of 4, right? And the second one has 5. So the common difference of this AP will be LCM of this, right? So LCM of 4 and 5, you have to find out. This will be the common difference of the new AP. So LCM of 4 and 5 is 20. Okay, and hence you can find out the and in that AP, the new AP which has been formed, the first term is 11, common difference is 20, so you have to find out the 10th term in this AP simply. Clear, Aryan? So whenever there is common terms have to be found out between two APs, this is what you have to do. Once again, okay, see, if you look at this series, let's look at this series. So if it is 3, 7, 11, 15, then what will happen? Next is 19, then 23, 27, 31. Okay. Here it is 1, 6, 11, 16, 21, 26, 31. Right? So if you see, these are the common terms. 11, the next common term is 31. Okay? So what will happen? If you take out the common terms from both, it will be of this term, this type, 11 and then 31. And then next you will see 51 will be there. Right? And how is this happening? Because there is a common difference d here. D1 is equal to 4 and d2 is equal to 5. So it's like after the LCM number of terms, LCM difference, LCM of d1 and d2 is 20. So after 20, again you will get a common term, right? So hence in this AP, the first term is 11 and the common difference is 20. So hence t10, 10th term will be 11 plus 9 into 20, which is, because if you see, this will go on, right? 11, 31, 51, 71, 91, so on and so forth. So for this AP, you have to find out the 10th term. So the answer is 191, right? So any two AP has a common term. No. Why do you say that? Let's say this is AP 1, 3, 5, 7 and 2, 4, 6, 8. Need not be. Okay. So let's go to the next question. Understood by all? Any difficulty here? Please let me know. Okay. So here is the next question. Sixty-four is divided into four parts such that they are in an AP. The product of first and last parts is 15/7 times that of the product of the second and third parts. Find the sum of first and the last parts. I hope this is easy. Very easy problem. This should have been solved mentally. This should have been solved mentally. Okay? See, you get trapped, all of you. Now the thing is, this question didn't require any sort of calculation. I don't know, you don't really read the question properly. This question didn't require any sort of any calculation. Why? Because if you see, 64 is divided into four parts, and we have discussed whenever you have to divide into four parts and all, what will you take? You will take a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus d, and a plus 3d. These are the four parts. Yes, so these are all useless information, not required at all. This was just to deviate you, distract you. You have to simply see this and this. Find the sum of the first and the last parts. Total is how much? If you add all of that, 4a. 4a is how much? 64. So a is 16. Okay, and then what? First and last parts is a minus 3d plus a plus 3d. That is 2a. So 2a is 32 over. Right? Yeah, that's what. So hence, so what is the learning? There will be questions which will be distractionary in nature. They will distract you. Yeah, so this distracted. Most of you got distracted, spent a lot of time. You lost focus on what was required. So always, always, always first fix your, you know, target on what is a desired end result, and then work backwards. You guys, the moment you'd have seen four parts, you'd have thought like this, but then this step distracted you all. Right? Clear? So in a competitive scenario, don't really work only on the method which you have learned. You have to keep an eye on the end result. In fact, you have to keep the eye only there. Okay. So nice, someone has got it. Okay. Chalo, next question. I hope you remember how to find out sum of all the angles of a polygon. Yeah, so last 3, 2, 1 and time's up. Could you solve this question? I hope. Let me see. Okay. So most of you, majority of you have got it, right? So this was an easy question. Simple, direct formula and you will get it. So basically there's a convex polygon and so one of the smallest angle is 120 degrees. So hence it's nothing but A is 120 degree here. And the difference between any two conjugative interior angle is 5 degrees, so given is D, 5 degrees. Okay, and then we have to simply do what? Sum of all these. Let's say there are n sides are there. So total angle sum property of a polygon, n-sided polygon, is n minus 2 into 180 degrees. This will be the total angle, correct? Now what you need to do is frame an equation. What is equation? So n number of sides, so n by 2. How do we know the other angles only increase? The difference between any two consecutive interior angles of a convex polygon is 5 degrees. Smallest angle is 120. Dude, smallest angle is given, smallest. So all the angle will be above it, right? So n by 2 into 2 into a, that is 120, plus n minus 1 into 5, right? 2a plus n minus 1 into 5, this is what it is equal to how much? This is equal to n minus n into 180 minus 360. This is the equation. You have to simply solve this. This will end up in what? A quadratic. So hence, if you see, the first one is 120n. First term, 2 gets cancelled, 120n plus 5n square. 5 by 2n square. Okay, so 5 by 2n square, correct? Just correct me if I'm wrong, and then minus 5n by 2. So minus 5 by 2n, right, is equal to 180n minus 360. So let's eliminate the 2 from the entire equation. So 240n plus 5n square minus 5n is equal to 360n minus 720. I can eliminate a 5 also. Okay, 5 also. So hence 548n plus n square minus n minus 572n and plus 5144 is equal to 0. This is the equation, right? So hence what will it be? N square, then how many n's are there? Minus 72n and minus 48, so 24 and minus 25, 25n plus 144. This is the quadratic equation, right? And from the options itself, we could have figured out that it is nothing but n square minus 16n minus 9n plus 144 is equal to 0. So that means if you solve it, you'll get n is equal to 9 and n is equal to 16. But why did you not mark 16? What happened, Anish? You are in trouble. What happened? Anish is saying something. Which side? Don't know, right? Increase or decrease is not stated. What is increase or decrease not stated? You are saying the angles could be 115 and 120, 110 and 105 like that, Anish. Is that your question? Is that your question, guy? Anish, one by one. Let me clarify Anish first and then. What is the doubt, Anish? I don't understand your doubt. Anish, can you hear me? Do you still have a doubt? Yeah, so what is the problem? Look, so be it, 120, 125, 130. And after 130, why would it go down? Oh, like that. Oh, like that. Acha. So you are saying 120, 125, 120, 125, 120, 125 like that. Yeah, okay, that is possible. But then again, yeah, it should be mentioned difference between any two constants. No, not like that. See, whenever it is said that difference between any two consecutive interior angle is like that, you take the second one and then the first one. Difference is always taken like this, in this manner. Later minus initial. Never initial minus later. Do you get that, Anish? So hence 5 degree is a positive angle. So hence you have to, so if this is the one, first one, and this is the second one, if difference is 5, that means T2 is more. You always take later minus initial. If it was minus 5, then it will come down, right? Then the consecutive will have a difference. So hence it will be progressive in nature. Coming to why 16 is wrong. 16 is wrong because if you take 16, you will get 195 as one of the last angle. Check it. So 120 plus 16 minus what? This will be the last angle, right? So 15 fives are 75. So 120 plus 75 is how much? 195. And in a convex polygon, how can a reflex angle be there? Do you get the point? Right? So there cannot be a reflex angle. So hence this was wrong. Not possible. So 9. Okay? Good. I hope you understood this. All doubts clear? Let's go to the next question. It's mentioned here. Check. And anyways, if in a polygon there is a reflex angle, it cannot you know, it will be what do you say, two arms will be crisscrossing each other. Okay, anyways, chalo, so this is good. Taman is showing real this thing. But why is Taman so calm in class? Taman, I will talk to you. Okay, chalo, do this. In an AP, if 3 times the 4th term is equal to 2 times the 7th term, the ratio of 7th and 10th term is. Okay, so last 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let me see, how did you perform? Oh, cool. Most of you have got it. It was very, very simple actually. You don't need to do any experiment here. So, clearly, if 3 times the 4th term, that means 3 into T4 is equal to what? 2 into T7. This is the equation. That means T4 by T7 is equal to what? 2 by 3. Isn't it? So what is 2 T4? A plus 3D, and T7 A plus 6D is equal to 2 upon 3. Cross multiply, you'll get 3A plus 9D is equal to 2A plus 12D. Okay, so hence you will get A is equal to 3D. The moment you got this, you have to find out T7 by T10, C7 upon T10. What is T7? T7 is A plus 6D and T10 is A plus 9D. Now replace or substitute A is equal to 3D. So you will get 3D plus 6D. So 3D plus 6D divided by 3D plus 9D. Which is nothing but 9 by 12, which is nothing but 3 by 4. Okay, clear? Is that okay? Now what is happening, Aditya? What is the issue? Okay, so yeah, all clear? Any doubt in this, guys? All clear? Yes, any doubt in this? Any X? No. So let's go to the next question. Before that, leaderboard. Good. Next question on board, guys. If the AM means arithmetic mean. If the AM between PS and QS terms of an AP be equal to the AM between its RS and SS terms, then which of the following is correct? Okay. Good. So I'm happy that all of you are able to do this. Okay. So in an AP again, so let me, yeah. So AP 3, oh sorry, this is the previous question. This question is, so question is, if the AM between PS and QS term of an AP be equal to AM between its RS and SS term. So AM between PS and QS term will be TP plus TQ upon 2, right? And the this is equal to PR plus TS upon 2, right? And now what? TP is equal to, let's say A and D were the parameters of the AP. So A plus N, sorry, P. P minus 1D plus A plus, so this 2 can be cancelled. So A plus Q minus 1D, right, is equal to A plus R minus 1D and plus A plus S minus 1D. So all A's will just get cancelled. And we will be left with all D's will also, 1, 1D will also get cancelled. If you see this one, this one, this one, and this one, all these D's, negative D's will get cancelled. So what do we get? All D's, anyways, D's also will get cancelled. So why only one? So D, D, D. One line answer, isn't it? So hence P plus Q is equal to R plus S you will get, which is nothing but this one. Right, so it was very easy. Okay. Now, next question, guys. In this question, assume that A and B and C are not equal. A, B, C are not equal. So majority correct, but most of you are making mistakes here. How many of you could not get it? Yep. X party. How many X party? I like the graph. Okay. Good. So many people are saying X. Okay. So let me solve this. So this is in AP, then let me also use some space over here. Okay, so what does it mean? If this is in AP, that means 1 upon C plus A minus 1 upon B plus C will be equal to what? 1 upon A plus B minus 1 upon C plus A. Common difference, right? Either okay, 1 upon a plus b minus 1 upon c plus a is equal to 1 upon c plus a minus 1 upon b plus c, right? So hence now take common denominator. So I can write here, let me write here. So this implies in the denominator you will get c plus a and b plus c, and in the numerator you will get simply b plus c minus a, isn't it? And here you will get again a plus b times c plus a, and in the numerator you will get c plus a minus b. Now if you see c plus a will get cancelled. Okay, they are not zero, so they will get cancelled. This c and this c will go, this a and this a will go. So it is basically b minus a by b plus c is equal to c minus b by what, a plus b. Simple. And then you need to just cross multiply and chill, relax. So hence it is b minus a, b plus a is nothing but b square minus a square. Okay, and this will be nothing but c square minus b square. That means what? A square, b square and c square are in AP. Okay, so hence, yes, clear? Everyone understood? So this is also a common difference. No, b square minus c square is equal to this is c square minus b square. So this is also a common difference. Okay, so hence it will, the moment you see such kind of a thing, that for example x minus y is equal to z minus y, sorry, y minus z, then xyz or zyx are in AP. Okay, so always remember this kind of relationship means these three numbers are in AP, whichever way, xyz or zyx. Okay, cool. So let's go to the next one. Nice. Sure, let's go to the next one. Now this is GP. Okay, so let me see. How was the question? Did you solve it on time? Oh, this shows some issue. Okay, that means only 9 people. Anyways, let me solve it. Sum of 3 numbers in AP is 21. Okay, so obviously you know the first step. What's the first step? You have to take what numbers are a minus, this is too light, so let us say a minus d, a and A plus D, right? These are the three terms in AP, and their sum is 21. So if you sum them, you'll get 3A is equal to 21. That means A is equal to 7. Okay. So what are the number terms? 7 minus D, 7, 7 plus D. And now what is being said? 1 is reduced. If the second number is reduced by 1, that means this becomes 6. And the third is increased by 1, that means it becomes 8 plus D. Okay, so 7 minus D, 6 and 8 plus D. The three resulting numbers are what? In GP. Okay, so what is GP, guys? So I know already, GP may common ratio will be same. So 6 by 7 minus D will be equal to 8 plus D by 6. This is what we know, right? So hence, it will give you 6 square is equal to 8 plus D and 7 minus D. So which is nothing but 56 and 8 minus 8 D plus 7 D. So minus D. And minus D square. Right? And this is 36. So that means D square plus D plus D square plus D minus, sorry, minus 20 is 0. Am I right? Right? So you'll get two values of D. D square, this is 5D minus 4D minus 20 is equal to 0. Splitting the middle term. So D, if you solve, you'll get D is equal to minus 5 or D is equal to 4. These two values. But since it is an increasing GP, right? So you got D is equal to 4. So you have to find out common ratio, right? So what is common ratio? 6 by 7 minus 4, which is 6 by 7 minus 4 is 3, so 2. So 2 is the right answer. Got it? You will not take minus 4 because then it will become, if you take minus 4, it becomes minus 5. If you take D as minus 5, then it becomes 12, so it becomes half. Then half common ratio will not be there. Why? Because it's an increasing GP. Is that clear? Bolo, any doubt? No doubt. Okay. Let's go to leaderboard. Good. Next. Then it's nth term, though the word term is missing here. Okay, nth term, you have to find out nth term. Good. So let's see if you are able to get this one. Still mixed, my God. That means GP is not very clear to everyone. Who all could not do it? You're struggling in GP, guys. You're struggling in GP. Okay, here. Sorry, this one. So, okay. Suppose m plus nth sum of a GP is p. So you know for a GP, p is equal to what? First term into common ratio to the power n minus 1. It will be m plus n minus 1. Simple. And m minus 1th term is q. So q is equal to a r m minus n minus 1. Simple. Divide these two equations. Divide these two equations. What will you get? You'll get p upon q is equal to a, and a will get cancelled, and r will see what? M plus n minus 1, and then minus m plus n plus 1 if you divide it. So that means m 1 1 will go. So p by q is equal to r to the power 2n. Okay, so what will be r? So you get r is p upon q whole to power 1 by 2n, and you have to find out nth term, right? So what will be nth term? So if you see nth term is a into r n minus 1. Correct. This is nth sum. Now, this will be nothing but a into r. So you have to basically find out a from somewhere. So in terms of p, so let's say from here, a is equal to nothing but p by r m plus n minus 1. Okay. So this is a. So what is a n? So nth sum will be tn is nothing but a. So what is a? P upon r m plus n minus 1 into r. What is r? P by q to the power 1 by 2n and then minus 1. This is the thing, right? Or rather, what you can do is you can keep this as r only. So let it be instead of that. Instead of that, write this as p upon r m plus n minus 1 into r n minus 1. So r n minus 1, that means this is nothing but p divided by simply r to the power m, because r n minus 1, n minus 1 will get cancelled. Isn't it? So p by r m, so which is nothing but p into r to the power m will be q by p whole to the power 1 by 2n. And isn't it? And m also, because there was an m here. So hence this matches with this one. What was the issue? Why did you make mistake here? What you found out? What was the problem? M instead. Mth term you found out. Mth term. Oh, why? It's clearly mentioned nth. Right, so hence, okay, so this is not correct, this is correct. Be careful. I have been telling this, and now by now I think I would have told you 1,000 times in the last 2 years. Be careful, be careful, be careful, be careful, be careful, 1,000 times. Anyways, chalo, let's go to the next question. Okay. A1, A2, A3, AN are in AP such that A4 minus A7 plus A10 is equal to M. Then sum of first 13 terms of the AP is. This should be easy, I believe. Simple nth term. So are you able to identify trend in the questions? In the questions are not dealing with numbers, numerals, so to say. Okay, there are lots of variables and lots of unknowns are, more unknowns are there in the question. That's how a typical competitive exam scenario would be. So you'll not be getting, okay, these are the 5, 7, 8, 9, these are the sum, these are the terms of AP 5, the 16th term and things like that. Very rarely in tough exams. Okay, so hence you have to be, and the other thing is we have not used anything which is beyond our knowledge. And third thing is it also involves knowledge of other topics, trigonometry or geometry and things like that. Good that most of you have got it. So I'll quickly solve this one. This was not very hard. So if you see this, this is A4. So you can directly write A4 as A plus 3D. Okay. A7 can be written as minus A plus 6D, and this can be written as A plus 10D, sorry, 9D. 9D. Yep, 9D. Right? And this is equal to M. So if you see A and A gets cancelled, A1, A will be left, and 3 minus 6 minus 3 and plus 6D is equal to M. A plus 6D is equal to M. Right, you want 13th term, so 13th term is A plus 12D, isn't it? Sorry, saying something. What is 13? Sum of the first 13 terms. My bad. Hence, so yeah, sum of first 13 terms is how much? 12 by 2, 13 by 2. My bad again, 13 by 2. First 13 terms is 13 by 2, and what else? Twice A, 2A plus 12D. So it is 13 upon 2 into 2 times A plus 6D. And A plus 6D was M, so 13 into M. Right? Clear? I hope this one is clear to you. So let's go to next question. Next question, guys, on the screen. The question says three positive numbers form an increasing GP. If the middle term of this GP is tripled, the new numbers are in AP. Then the common ratio of GP is. Okay, so now Let me see your performance. Okay. Wow. So you guys need to revisit the topics on GP. Okay, anyways, GP and HP. I hope it is covered in all the batches, right? All of you have covered GP? Yes or no? Everywhere it is covered, right? Okay, never mind. Sure. So if A1, A2, A3 are in AP, this is the previous question. So go to the next one. Yeah. So how to go about it? Three positive numbers form an increasing GP. So the moment this is there, what do you need to do? It's A upon R, A and AR are the three numbers in GP, increasing GP. Right? You can always, where R is greater than 1. R is greater than 1 because it is increasing GP. If the middle term in this GP is tripled, that means 3A, then A upon R and 3A and AR are in AP. The new numbers are in AP. These numbers are in AP. AP meaning what? 3A minus A upon R, common difference, is equal to AR minus 3A, or 2 into 3A is equal to AR plus A by R. So AA will cancel. So 6 is equal to R plus 1 upon R. So R square, if you do minus 6R plus 1 is 0. This is a quadratic equation. You have to solve for R. So R will be minus B. 6 plus minus B square, that is 36. Minus 4AC. Minus 4 by twice A. So twice A is 2 only. Right? So this is nothing but 6 plus minus 36 minus 4, 32. That is 2, 4 root 2. 4 root 2 divided by 2. Okay, so what will this be? It will be 3 plus minus 2 root 2. But if you take 3 minus 2 root 2, then it will be less than 1. So only 3 plus, sorry, what? Yeah. So D. What was the right answer? 3 plus 2 root 3. What did I say? Answer is wrong, is it? Just a minute. Let me verify. Yeah, 3 plus 2 root 2 should be there. Oh, 3 plus 2 root 2. So, this root was extra. Actually, this one root was extra. Oh, sorry, bad. So, let me delete this question. Wait. So, you all mark, question number 11 it was, right? So, question number 11, you have marked A. So, all of you should mark A. I am resetting the result. Reset result. This slide. Reset. Okay. So, I am going back to this one. Okay, so I have reset the result in question number 11. Wait, no, I could not. Wait a minute. This was after 11th, no? So let me reset it. Just hold on, guys. Just hold on. Yes, so this was 11th question. Yeah, I have reset it now. No problem. So we can go back to presentation. Yeah, so all of you just mark A so that you all of you get the same score. A, mark it so that none of you are at disadvantage. Yeah, so just mark A. Answer was 3 plus 2 root 2, but it is actually 3. So by mistake, it is mentioned as 2 root 3. Okay, just quickly mark all of you so that I can proceed with the quiz. You should say all of you have voted. All of you have voted. Come on, come on, come on, quick. Don't waste 1 minute time on this. No R&D, RM in the middle of anything. So the best, whatever is possible, is done. So I just need everyone to vote. So 49 people. Still people are waiting for voting. I don't know why. What are they doing? So they have just, because of their parental pressure or whatever, they have logged in and they are moving around. Or they have put some, so these are all insights for us as well. No? They have put some speakers on their headphones on and they are listening to music. Here, oblivion to what's happening in the quiz. So there are all sorts, varieties of people are there. Anyways. So, okay. Next. So, I will see. Good. Never mind. So, let's go to the next last question, guys. Here is the question. Attention, attention, attention. Now there is an element of HP also. I hope you understand that. Okay, so the final 10 seconds, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I hope you got it correct at least this time. Okay. 20 people got it. So good staircase graph. Let me solve this one. So 6 is the right answer. Correct. And why is this? So you know, this was fairly simple. A1, A2, A10 is in AP. So A1 is 2. So A1 is 2. And A10 is 3. A10 is equal to 3. So you can find out D. Correct? So what is this? A10. A10 is equal to A1 plus 9D. Right? So A10 is 3 and A1 is 2. So 9D. So D will be equal to 1 by 9. Right? This is D. So you can find out A4 first of all. So A4 is nothing but A plus 3D. So 3 into 1 by 9, which is 2 plus 1 by 3. 2 plus 1 by 3, which is 7 upon 3. So this is about A4. A4, you got it. Next is HP. Let's take HP. So 1 by H1, H2, H10 are in HP. That means 1 upon H1, 1 upon H2. 1 upon H10 are in AP. That is what is the definition of HP, right? So H1 is given 2. So here the first term is 1 upon 2. And H10 is also given 3. So the 10th term is 1 upon 3. Okay. Now let's the common difference be D1 in this case. So I can say 1 upon 3 minus 1 upon 2, or 1 upon 3 is equal to, sorry, first term, so 1 by 2 plus 9 D1, right? So here it will be 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 9d1, right? So what will be d1? So this is nothing but 2 minus 1 by 1 by 6. This is 1 minus 6 is equal to 9d1. So d1 will be equal to minus 1 upon 54. You got d1. So 10th term will be easier to find out. So 10th term will be how much? First term, that is 1 by 2. So t10 of the inverted HP term, that is AP, right? What t10 will be? First term was half plus 9d. So 9 into minus 1 by 54. Okay, so 9d1, so which is anyways minus 1 by 6. So half minus 1 by 6 will be 3.
Yeah. Sir, you have to find h7.
Oh, sorry, sorry. So it will not help. So
h10 is already given us.
Yeah, sorry, my bad. Yeah, so hence we have to find out h7, sorry. Yeah. So how to find out h7? Easy. So t7 is half. And what? 6 into minus 1 by 54. This is t7. So what is this value? This value is half into 6. 1 minus 1 by 9. So 18 and 9 minus 7. Sorry, plus 7. 7 by 18. So h7 is 18 by 7, isn't it? This is H7. You have to reciprocate this term to get H7. So this is H7. So A4 into H7 is equal to A4 was 7 upon 3 into 18 by 7, which is 6. So this. Got it? Okay. So this is what we have done today. Let's see who is the winner of the quiz. So one question was wrong, and here is, so Meghna is the winner of the quiz. Very good, keep it up. So Meghna, Athira, Shreyas, Pranav, Sanjana, Ariman, Aniket, Smriti, Alisha, Laksh. Good. Good guys, very good. Nice, so keep it up. Let's meet again. How many of you would be interested in a geography quiz? I just need your response. Geography quiz. All of you? Okay. Fair enough. So I have already kind of framed the questions. And geography quiz will be mostly open book. So you have to just keep your NCERT book in front of you. And you can solve questions from there. Okay, so take care guys. Okay, bye-bye. And questions on Mockstra. Okay, bye-bye, take care, see you, stay safe.
So when will the geography quiz be?
So it's anyways open book, whenever it takes place just participate.
Yes.
Okay. We'll tell you. First chapter. Geography, first chapter.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye. Take care.